Speaker TV.
Hi Speaker TV, I'm Matt.
And Nick.
And we're from the band British India.
And we hope you enjoy whatever it is that you're about to play of us now.
If anything.
Releasing our third record in March, probably. We don't actually have a name. We've gone through a few old boxes.
Pile of old boxes, painted as a nun.
On the lawn.
On the lawn.
These are not actually.
Throw me at the statue. Avalanches.
Avalanches.
Fluid Thief.
We're not going to go with Avalanches.
Why not?
Isn't there a band called the Avalanches?
Only one album.
No, they released two today.
Well, DJ Dexter left. And then they released another one pretty recently.
No, they didn't release another one.
I'm pretty sure they did.
Well,
yeah, they did like 2 years ago.
But I'd like to call the record Avalanches. I mean, it's a good word, and I don't see why we shouldn't be able to share it. We're both from Melbourne, I'm sure they'd be gentlemen about it.
We've released a single off it this week. It's called Vanilla.
Vanilla by definition
and it's on
is dull. But
on its own, it's always, an excitement factor about vanilla. You can always do something to it.
Any time that we play a live gig is always, great. But recording is, especially this last, the recording we've been doing recently has just been such a... an enjoyable experience, because there's been the way that we've been communicating with each other, like songwriting wise, has been better than ever, but there's also enough tension in the band room that it creates something good. Like, there's always and it's something that you kind of need.
Well said there, Will.
Thanks, man.
We're in the studio now just kicking around ideas with just the four of us basically and a producer, Glenn Goldsmith, who we're working with. And just being able to have that much control, it's really great. It's a real lot of fun, and it's hard to do in this country, I think, to tour as extensive as we do, I think, again, it's hard to do.
Why is it hard?
Because there's not much of a market here. I think people are more interested in, a lot of dance music and a lot of pop music again. I think rock and roll came back for a while, but, it's kind of running at parallels with this dancing that's probably people are more willing to spend their money on.
It is hard to initially get your groundswell up so you can have a tour around Australia so you can play that live show, but there's so many different places to play in Australia that hold 200 people or more. Any band that's being played on Triple J should be out there playing, and there's a lot of bands that don't take advantage of that. Even a lot of big bands on Triple J don't take advantage of that.
I think especially with the labels and the majors kind of going the way they are, extensive touring is going to have to become, more of a money-making, more of an income for a lot more bands. I think it's going to kind of have to go back to year zero in that regard. And I like to think the British
like
India
the
kind
movie?
Of...
Year
yeah,
one?
Yeah, exactly like that. Starring Sarah, Michael Sarah. As far as, rigorous touring, I think that's something that's going to come back a lot more as bands have to look for new ways to make money.
It'll be a pretty quiet summer for us. We'll do a few shows here and there. Yeah, we're doing Pyramid, but...
A few other festivals here and there, but...
Yeah, we're going to be pretty quiet because our album comes out in March. Yeah. We don't want to go to play a whole bunch of shows with a whole bunch of new songs where people are going, what the fuck are these guys playing? Well, this band used to be good!
Hey there, everyone. This is British India. My name is Declan.
I'm Will, and you're watching Speaker TV.
Keep music evil out there. All right. Yeah.